Hey everyone, this is a JavaScript Strings tutorial, and in this video, we are going to get a quick introduction to string data types in JavaScript. We will create strings in JavaScript using the traditional syntax of single quotes and double quotes. We will also look at how you can create strings using template literals in JavaScript. So stick around till the end of the video to get a complete understanding of the string literal syntax as well as the traditional syntax of declaring and working with JavaScript strings. Before ES6, JavaScript had two syntaxes for declaring strings, which are very much valid as of now. Let's have a quick look at them. Let's start by defining two variables which use different syntax. Let first name is equal to John with double quotes. Let last name is equal to Doe with single quotes. The only difference that we have here is that the first name has been declared using double quotes and the last name has been declared using single quotes. Unlike some other C-type languages like PHP, which interpret strings differently based on whether they are declared using single quotes or double quotes, JavaScript makes no differentiation. In JavaScript, it doesn't really matter whether a string has been declared using single quotes or double quotes. We can check both the variables using typeof and see what is returned in the console. You see, JavaScript treats both of them as strings with no differentiation at all. Cool. Now let's look at a new way of declaring strings in JavaScript, which was introduced in ES6, known as template literals. Declaring strings using template literals is super easy. Let middle name is equal to Smith. You see, I'm using backticks over here. These are not single quotes. Let's check the type of this variable as well in our console. Now you'll see that the console returns string. There is more to template literals and the kind of additional features they bring to ES6. I consider string literals to be the ES6's answer to multiline strings in JavaScript because that's the first thing that they bring on the plate. With template literals, writing multiline strings has become really easy. Let's have a look at how developers used to write multiline strings in JavaScript before this new syntax. Let's assume that we need the following text to be printed in two lines, like so. My name is John Doe. I'm a web developer. Now, if we had to do this using double quotes or single quotes, it would look something like this. Let multiline is equal to. And then we say, my name is John Doe in double quotes. Then we use the concatenation character plus sign followed by this escape character. Again, concatenate. And then I'm a web developer in double quotes. Now, it's not necessary to have these two lines in different lines in your code, but developers working on JavaScript and having used it before ES6 era would tell you that formatting like this was normal. Try to imagine multiple lines and each had to be separated by a new line character, certainly a nightmare. I'll print this to the console quickly so that we can see how it looks like. Console.log multiline. You see, it gives our desired results. Now, what if we had to use template literals instead? Let's have a look. let new multiline is equal to a backtick, and then I can copy my text here. My name is John Doe, I'm a web developer, and then closing the backtick. Let's see the output by printing this to the console. Console.log new multiline. We get the desired result here as well. If we look at our previous example, here we have John Doe passed as a string value. What if we were supposed to dynamically populate this using the value stored in our variables? This is what we are going to do now. So here, I'm going to replace John Doe with our variable here, first name. And then in order to give space, I would have to use double quotes with a space between them and followed by the last name variable. Let's see what this prints to our console. We do get our desired result, but try to imagine a situation where you have to concatenate strings and variables in long text or page and have to use this kind of a syntax. After a certain time, it barely remains readable. This is where string interpolation offered by template literals really becomes handy. Let's see how you can take advantage of that. So you can use the special syntax of a dollar sign followed by your variable encapsulated by curly braces to tell JavaScript that value of this variable needs to be converted to a string. The beauty here is that you do not have to use any concatenation to add spaces. You can simply type your sentences as you would naturally with spaces and use string interpolation to print values using your variables. Let's check if this gives us the desired results. Here we have it, the way we wanted it. One thing to point out here, it's not just variables, you can use any JavaScript expressions to be converted to string values between this syntactic sugar provided by template literals. I'm coming up with more such videos and a complete series on tricky parts of JavaScript and lots of advanced concepts as well. If there are some specific questions related to this video, you can post them in the comments below and I will answer them for you. Please consider subscribing to my channel so that you're able to watch the most recent videos, and that helps me a lot with the YouTube algorithm as well. I will see you in the next video. Till then, you take care. Cheers.